friends, welcome to another session of Sharekhan Pre-Market Action with Misha Ji Nair. Firstly, the Asian indices. Yesterday, both Nikkei and Hang Seng were up around 0.9%, whereas back home, Nifty started on a positive note, was up with a gap of opening, but quickly lost all its gains and soon it fell to lower levels. And it over the session, it was not able to recoup the losses and managed to close around 20 points lower. The movers in the Nifty were Tata Motors and Tata Steel, whereas the movers on the lower side were Sun Pharma and TCS. The FIs yesterday, or the fund flow, the FIs were net sellers to a tune of 115 crore, whereas the DIs were net buyers to a tune of 60 crores. The FIs in the future segment were net buyers to the tune of 599 crores. So that's a good figure. With respect to the European markets yesterday, were 0.6% odd down. That goes for FTSE, CAC and DAX as well. They're close to 0.6% down. Whereas the Dow Jones yesterday ended 0.5% lower on the back of a slump in energy shares. So today morning, what we are seeing is Nikkei is around 0.5% negative, whereas the Hang Seng is close to 0.4% positive. So a bit of mixed cues for the Indian market. SGX is currently trading 17 points down. So we may have a muted start considering the global indices, how they had reacted yesterday. So we may have a muted start in the morning. But the numbers yesterday, some good numbers with respect to the GDP growth as well as the core data, growth data. That was good. So possibly some spillover of the positiveness of the Indian economy into our markets may be seen, whereas the global cues are a bit negative. So maybe a mixed kind of reactions that are coming from the global as well as the domestic side, and we may see a slightly positive to a muted start in the morning today. And now over to the derivatives update.
Good morning, friends. We'll give analysis on derivatives. Yesterday's trading session was yet another trading session where we have seen Nifty was quite on a flattish note. It started on a flattish note and thereon it consolidated in a narrow range of 10 to 20 odd points and oscillated between negative and positive territory throughout the day. It was again one kind of a trading day where Nifty, there was an up pause in an uptrend where Nifty hardly showed any kind of a movement and eventually closed with a minor loss of 0.04%, absolutely on a flattish note at 8190.90. Now on the open interest terms, not much of activity and build up of around 0.28% was observed in the absolute terms. 63,000 shares were added in open interest. Cost of carry also increased from 2.5% to 4.5%. That is, Nifty premium did went up from anywhere from 15 points to 30 points currently. Indeed, majority of the addition, however, it was very minor. But whatever kind of in position which was been built up in yesterday's trade was on the longer side. Put call ratio have decreased a bit by 1 basis point from 1.03 to 1.02, and volatility index have inched higher by 50 basis, that is by half a percentage, from 16.05, from 15.98 to 16.05 odd levels. Now on the options activity, not major activity to highlight. On the call side, 8,300 call option have seen the highest addition in yesterday's trade of with around 13% odd, while 8,400 continues to be the highest in terms of open interest for this series. While on the put side, 8,000 strike price continues to add significant amount of positions in the in it, and it is now the highest in terms of open interest with around 60 lakh shares in it, which is quite huge. And for the this expiry, it's difficult for the market to go below 8,000, as 8,000 volatility is a very crucial support for the market and very strong support for a market. While 8,200 put option, 8,100 had seen hardly any addition in the open interest. So overall, seeing the data, the outlook of the market remains positive. There is hardly any change in the parameters or in the data of the in derivatives. So outlook remains positive. In today's trading session, our main highlight would be 8,200 activity of 8,200 call option. Nifty is trying to go past 8,200, but is not able to sustain above it. And unwinding 8,200 call option will result in a convincing upside above 8,200 and can sustain above it. So the activity of 8,200 call option would be in focus in today's trading session. There are no securities in banned period for today's trade on FIS terms and index futures. They continue to be net buyers in yesterday's trade also. They were net buyers by 600 crores. And the open interest went down by 2-3% indicating some short covering by them. Index options net sellers by 63 crores. Stock futures net sellers by 254 crores. And stock options net buyers by 50 crores only. On the market level, 5 days wave stands at 8115 with a lower range at 8115 and higher range at 8250. SGX Nifty is trading positive, it's up by 19 odd points and could open anywhere around above 8200 at 8207, indicating some kind of a positive opening can be expected in the morning trade. That's it from derivatives, thank you.
So friends, we'll now take a look at the trading ideas for the day, the equity trading ideas. On our first idea, we have Axis Bank. Now, FIs can now invest up to 62% under the portfolio investment scheme. So, this is a positive development for Axis Bank. We feel that one can go long on Axis Bank, keeping a stop loss at 504 for an upside target of 530 and 540. On the next trading idea, we have the trading idea for oil marketing companies. Yesterday midnight, petrol price was raised by 2.58 rupees, whereas diesel was raised by 2.26 rupees per litre. So these are positive developments for the oil marketing companies, and we feel that one can go long on BPCL with a stop loss of 961 for an upside target of 1010 and 1030. And another oil marketing company which can be positive today is HPCL. And one can keep the stop loss at 888 for an upside target at 934 and 952. On our news update section, the fiscal deficit for 2016 came in at 3.9% of GDP. And another positive number yesterday was the GDP came at 7.9% versus CNBC's expectations or poll of 7.6%. RIL Arm sells its entire 76% stake in African fuel retailer, that is Gulf Africa Petroleum Corporation, and Reliance Industries temporarily shuts 2 units at Dahej due to water shortage. SEBI has eased redemption norms for mutual fund investors, and Maruti is to resume production at Gurgaon plant. Manesar plant is on hold. ONGC Videsh Limited has signed a MOU with the SOCAR Trading SA, that is the government arm of Azerbaijan, for foraying into oil trading business. And also another news on ONGC Videsh has announced completion of the acquisition of 15% stake in Russia's second biggest oil field of Vankor from Rosneft for $1.268 billion. And Tata JLR process 5 lakh vehicle mark, so that's a landmark number of vehicles that has crossed. Hero Motor has launched its own online booking website, and Orient Cement is in talks to buy KGS Cement. The deal is likely to be valued around 1500 crores. Also, auto player Subros to supply to Maruti from alternate Noida plant. The Maruti is trying to bring the Manesar plant back in track very fast. So that is a positive news for Maruti. State Bank of India is in the process of launching a large fund for investments in distressed assets. It is in talks with two private players, Warburg Pincus, and two other sovereign wealth funds from Middle East to raise about $3 billion. And Vakrangi ties up with logistics company LMX. And on a results update, we have Aurobindo Pharma's. It came out with good set of numbers yesterday. The stock was doing pretty well. So strong operating profit. We have a positive outlook. We maintain buy with the revised price target of 885. Sun Pharma, yesterday the stock was down on the back of numbers which were slightly disappointing or which did not meet the consensus. Also, based on the guidance the management gave, the stock was down yesterday. But we continue to feel that it has a stable long-term outlook and maintain buy with a target price of 945. And SAIL had reported numbers yesterday. It reported loss of 1,230 crores versus 334 crores in the fiscal period a year ago, and this was due to lower steel prices. And this is our watchlist section. Based on derivative data, we feel a few stocks have positive bias. Among them are Bata, Motherson Sumi and Arvind. On stocks with negative bias, we have REC Limited, Titan and Bajaj Finance. On stocks for investment, we have BEL, HDFC Bank, Maruti, Hindustan Unilever and Glenmark. So that's it from the advisory section, and thanks for tuning in. Happy trading and happy investing.